welcome back to Cameron's Aggie Gym in Lawton, Oklahoma. Charlie Chitwood here, joined now up in the rafters by women's head coach Jason Burton. Hey, fresh off of an 83-78 win, let's start checking off the boxes. 24 wins to start the season. Not a bad winning streak, Coach.
Not a bad winning streak. 18 conference wins in a row. That's, you know,
18.
That's probably the more important one right there.
And 8-0 in divisional play. And Coach, you can't be caught now. There's not enough regular season left for anybody in our division to catch up to the Lions mathematically. The first crown is already yours.
Yes. That's big. You know, that's very big. With this new conference to be the first division champions in this division. And it's to be able to keep this focus, man. This is a tough place to play. We talked about it before the game. You know that this team was going to score the ball. And you got to find a way to outscore them. And I thought we kept our poise in the fourth quarter, because the third quarter I thought we came out, man. We came out in attack mode. We did what we needed to do. We stretched that lead out, and then they came right back and they made their run. And, you know, Coach Emma has this team that's playing hard. They're playing really hard. They're focused. They play together. They play from start to finish. And I thought even down the stretch, man, they had, you know, if they have two more minutes, that game might go differently. So, but great job by our team, but just finding a way to win on the road and bringing this thing back to Commerce.
Coach, talk about the message in the locker room at halftime. You were up by six then, and boy, did they come out with their foot on the gas, though.
Yeah, so at halftime, we talked about a couple of things. We talked about mainly like taking away the middle drive. Their middle drive created so much for them offensively. And when they weren't getting a layup, they dumped down to the post, or it was dumped down to the post and kicked back out for a three, and they were just getting open looks. And when we started forcing them to go baseline, it just made things tougher for them. And I thought defensively we tightened up a little bit in the third quarter, but we also were able to score. I think Alexis Bryant got her confidence a little bit back in that quarter. And then Desiree Kernan was a beast, 12 for 12 from the free throw line, but just having that thought process to get to the free throw line, to go through hands and not expect things, but go to score. And I thought she did a great job. We did a great job of feeding her the ball, and then in the fourth quarter, I found a way to get it done.
Coach, she had, I'm talking about Desiree Kernel, 17 points.
Beast.
And 10 rebounds. If you count the free throws, you could call it a triple-double, I suppose, if you wanted. However, that's all in front of a bunch of friends and family that made it down from Kansas.
Yeah.
You might be sending some bus money up there before long if she plays like that.
Yeah, hopefully they'll make it back down to our Oklahoma Christian game, and hopefully they make it down to some more games, NCAA tournament. But she's been playing well. We talked about that before the game. I thought our forward spot was a huge bright spot for us today. You look at Juliana Lewis, 9 points, 10 rebounds. I thought a Jong Tak defensively was great. And then a double-double with 17 and 10 from Desiree Kernel. They really stepped up and played big from that forward spot. And Kernel has been really, really figuring some things out. We've asked so much of her freshman year, just playing so many different spots and knowing the different roles and being able to know the guard spots and the forward spots. She's really played well this year. So hats off to her with a big game in front of her family.
Tell you what, your other freshman, Deani Robinson, didn't do too bad off the bench either. 6 points, 4 assists, 7 rebounds to go along with a steal. What did you think of her in this fast-paced game? She's the fastest one on the floor.
There's some fast guards out there, and she is. And she's continuing to learn how to play at this pace as far as running the team. But, you know, and I think when she gets more comfortable going right now, because at times she gets left-hand dominant, and there's some plays that if she'll go right, she can get to the basket. But she's growing so much from the start of this year to right now and learning how to affect the game, not just scoring, because at the beginning of the year, it was all about how can I score. But you see her having 7 rebounds today. You see her guarding their best players today. And she did a tremendous job defensively for us, because it's not an easy guard. It's a tough guard, and she did a really good job for us today.
Coach, y'all were able to clamp down. Ava Batiste, of course, is the one you worry about most. And when she leaves a game with only 18 points, you feel like you've defended her pretty well, especially at the three line. 5 out of 16, that's 5 threes, but she took a lot more than that.
Well, we did a heck of a job on Megan Hedge, who's the second leading scorer in the Lone Star Conference,
right,
averaging 20 points a game. And so to hold her to 13, and I thought we were a little, we weren't as tight to Ava as I would have liked us to be today. But still, we made all her shots tough. She shot 16 threes and only made 5. I thought we did a good job of making tough shots for her. But Amaka got off, and she's a heck of a player. She's a player that they missed last year. And she just brings so much as far as, man, she's tough to keep in front of them. If you don't get yourself moving laterally quickly. She gets ahead of steam and she's going to the basket, and she really hurt us as far as penetration. If she wasn't scoring, she made the right play and found the right person who was open for a shot. This is a team that we may see again. You know, when you start looking at how the conference is shaping up, and they're hovering around that 8-9 spot, because really 6-10 is really, really tight right now, and they could very easily finish in that 8-9 game, and then we may play them in the first round. So we've got to make sure we watch this film. We're ready to make some adjustments the next time we play them. But to our credit, though, I thought things that we do well, we did well today. We didn't take care of the ball, which that was kind of the X factor why the game was so close. 22 turnovers is way too much. But yep. How we dominated the boards and how we dominated the paint, shooting 40 free throws and getting – we out-rebounded by almost 20 rebounds, 19 rebounds.
And
that's what we do well. 57.
57 yeah. Rebounds. That's a ton of boards.
Right. Right. And I thought our focus of going inside, we made it tough for them. We got them in foul trouble, and that really helped us today.
All right, Coach. You say that. You got them into foul trouble. You were at the line in all four quarters. They meant to put you there in the fourth, of course, trying to slow the game down and get to the free throw line or make more time for themselves. But that inside attack, they just really didn't have an answer in there for most of the game.
Yeah, and you got to knock down free throws down the stretch. 6 of 9, you hope it's closer to that 9 for 9, 8 for 9 in the fourth quarter. But throughout the game, and we hit free throws, 83% from the free throw line. When you shoot 40 free throws, I think you're going to win most games. And shout out to Desiree Colonel again, 12 for 12. I think Josh Meng, the best stat guy in the land, told us that that's the highest free throw percentage as far as makes. 12 for 12 is the most makes going 100% this year in the Lone Star Conference. And so for her to do that.
Five
off the record.
Yeah, it would have taken 17. But it's kind of like winning 24 games. You get up so far, it's like, wow, they did it again. Hey, wow, they did it again.
She probably got fouled another four times and probably should have shot about 8 more free throws, but that's another topic of discussion.
All right. Well, Coach, congratulations. Number 24 in the books. Let's go home and get ready for your old buddy Josh Brock from Eastern New Mexico and then the Lady
Buffs
on Saturday.
It's going to be a special
Saturday.
Week. It's our last two regular season home games, and, we got a chance next week to secure a number one seed in the Lone Star Conference tournament with both Lubbock Christian and West Texas A&M only having three losses. If we can win the next two games, then we secure that number one seed. And so that's our goal right now, is to be able to go into Frisco, the number one seed, and hopefully, regional rankings come out next week. We should be number one in the region and secure that. Finish the season out number one in the region as well. So that's our goal right now, and got to make sure we take care of business.
All right. Alex said don't come home without a win, so you can go home again, Coach.
We can.
Another successful road trip.
I can.
Now you can go take care of her for Valentine's Day.
Yes, sir. Thank you.